Hello everyone and welcome to Qt Explained. I'm your host Gunther, and in today's episode we're diving into the exciting world of WebAssembly and how you can use Qt to run your applications right in your web browser. So stay tuned and let's explore this incredible technology together. All right, let's dive into the world of WebAssembly, or WASM for short. WebAssembly is a compact binary format that's designed to be executed in web browsers with near-native performance. What does it mean exactly? Well, imagine running complex software in your browser at speeds almost as fast as if you're running it natively on your computer. That's the power of WebAssembly. Now, what sets WebAssembly apart is that it's not some proprietary technology. It's an open standard developed by the W3C community group, which includes representatives from all major web browsers. So you've got Chrome, Firefox, Safari, and Edge all on board. This means WASM is universally supported, future-proof, and the official common solution for bringing native applications to the web. And here's where it gets really exciting. With WebAssembly, you don't need any third-party plugins to run the applications in the browser. You might remember the days of Adobe Flash, Java Servlets, or Microsoft Silverlight. These solutions required certain programming languages, frameworks, and tools, and their own browser plugins, thus making its usage hard for both developers and the end users. WebAssembly sidesteps all of that. It is a common standard that's compatible with any existing programming language like C++, Rust, C#, Go, or even Python. And your users won't even have to download or install anything extra. They can directly enjoy your WebAssembly-powered application with their favorite web browser. Whether you are developing complex business apps, games with stunning visuals, or anything in between, WebAssembly opens up a world of possibilities. It's a big part of the future of web development, and it's here to stay. Sounds amazing? Then let's explore how you can use Qt to power your WebAssembly application so you can leverage this technology in your own projects. Before we can build and deploy a WebAssembly application with Qt, we need to prepare all the tools. First, make sure to add the WebAssembly build kits to your Qt installation. You can do so with the maintenance tool. There's a multi-threaded and also a single-threaded build kit available. In addition, you also need the mscripten compiler to build the application. It's best to follow the instructions in the Qt documentation and the mscripten website. First, check out the EM SDK from GitHub and use the command line to install and activate the correct mscripten version that matches your Qt version. For example, for Qt 6.5.2, this would be mscripten 3.1.25. Then open Qt Creator, navigate to the device's WebAssembly settings, and specify the path to your installed EM SDK. That's it. You can now use the Qt build kits for WebAssembly, just like the ones you know for desktop or mobile development. With this setup, Qt Creator can use the EM SDK to compile C++ code into WebAssembly. The simple example project that I have here shows a light yellow background with a button in the center. Let's test it on macOS first. This is how it looks. Now we can simply switch the build kit to WebAssembly and compile the app for the browser. Running the project with Qt Creator will automatically start a local web server and deploy the application, which makes testing easy. A browser window will open up and show your web app. After making some changes to the code, we can just build and run again to see the result. If you want to manually deploy it to a local or a remote web server, you can find the WebAssembly binary together with the HTML root file and some basic JavaScript for initialization in the build folder. So, with all the basics covered, let's take a quick look at some demos and showcases powered by the Felgo SDK. Felgo makes working with WebAssembly even easier, because you get a fully functional and pre-configured Qt and mscripten toolchain out of the box. So you do not have to worry about configuring the right versions and matching everything up so that it works together. In addition, the Felgo SDK includes many components that you can use to create responsive cross-platform UIs that look great on mobile, embedded, desktop, and of course the web. But that's not all. With Falgo's web editor, you can even code Qt Quick right in your browser and see the result in real time. This is made possible by combining WebAssembly with Falgo's QML hot reload technology. If you're interested to learn more and try it out yourself, check out the links in the description. To summarize, Qt for WebAssembly enables us to run applications in the browser with near-native performance, and it's a future-proof open standard that is backed by all the major web browsers. It's clear that this technology is a game-changer for finally bridging the gap between native development and web development. But it's essential to acknowledge the current limitations too. The emscripten compiler and WebAssembly standards continue to evolve, and the browsers are still in the process of adapting to the new technology. Some ongoing challenges include the proper handling of threading, how to manage a virtual file system and storage within the browser, or bringing all of the Qt modules that we know and love into the web. You can see the Qt documentation for more information on the supported modules and ongoing developments. But the future of WebAssembly is bright, and the technology is continually improving and getting better. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, hit the like button, and activate the notification bell. Your support means a lot and keeps us motivated to bring you more exciting content like this. If you have suggestions for future video topics, feel free to drop us a comment below and let us know. Thank you for joining and stay tuned for more. See you next time.